Welcome everyone, and thanks for joining us as today we shine a spotlight on the shipwreck of the SS Wexford. The Wexford was built by Doxford Williams & Sons Limited at Sunderland, Great Britain in 1883. She was a 250-foot steel-hulled, steam-powered, propeller-driven bulk lake freighter. This vessel had many owners during her life. While originally christened the Wexford in 1883, from 1898 until 1903, she was renamed the SS Elise. And in 1903, she reclaimed the Wexford name. Owned by Western Steamship Company of Toronto at the time of her sinking, her cargo was steel rails as well as 96,000 bushels of wheat. While en route from Thunder Bay, Ontario to Goderich, piloted by Captain Bruce Cameron, approximately 9 miles northwest of Grand Bend, Ontario, the ship was lost beneath the waves of Lake Huron in November of 1913. While the exact numbers are unclear, it is said that between 17 and 24 crew members on board perished when the ship was overcome by heavy seas and high winds during one of the worst storms in Great Lakes history that scuttled 8 such lake freighters, among others. Wexford was the first one discovered that was sitting upright on the lake bed. Claims of the Wexford shipwreck's discovery date back as far as 1975, it wasn't until August 25th of the year 2000 that the wreck was discovered and actually identified, sitting intact and upright in 75 feet of water. Anchors at the bow are a highlight of this wreck. There is also a third anchor near ship stern on the main deck. The site is now permanently marked with a large mooring buoy and monitored by the Canadian Coast Guard, who encourage low impact diving that assists in preservation of the wreck site. in 2013, a copper wreath was placed on the wreck to honor the crew on the 100th anniversary of the Great Storm of 1913. Thank you for taking the time to explore the Wexford with us. There are other great dives on my YouTube channel. And I'd like to say a special thank you to Mike Bridgman and Rob Fox for your amazing camera work on this dive.